Today we are going to learn about the RC charging circuit. Now if you see the RC charging circuit, now let us, this is your RC charging circuit. This is the 5 volt has been applied and this is R and C has been connected in series, and here we are going to supply 5 volt DC. For that what we are going to do, just going to draw that circuit. Now let me enlarge this one. Now let us delete all this point. Now go to voltage. This is your voltage. Put the escape button and just enlarge for you. I'm just enlarging for your better understanding. This is your voltage. Now take R from here, make 3 rotation. This is your R and take your C. Now this is your RC circuit. Now just connect with the wire. This is how the connection is made. This is RC circuit. Now just connect the ground path so that circuit will be completed. Now you need to connect the ground path so that circuit will be completed. Now this is your RC. Now put the value. What is that value? 47k. Just left click, put the 47k. It will take kilo ohm. Now here you put the 1000 microfarad. This is your 1000. Just like U, it will take mu microfarad. And here we need to give the 5 volt. 5 we have given. Now we will be running the simulation. Now at till what time we will be running the simulation? Now let us see. Now if you see the charging time, means tau, time constant is around 47 seconds. At least we must run the simulation 10 times more than this one. 47 into 10 means 470 seconds. Now we are going to run this simulation for 470 seconds. Now it is simulation. Go to tangent, just write 470 seconds. And start external DC supply voltage at 0. Okay, put here, run this one. Now we need to check the voltage so that we can proceed further. Now if you see, if I tap here, it will give our voltage. Now this is the charging. Now if you see the input voltage, now I am plotting the input voltage. Now if you see, this is our input voltage has been applied and a charging of capacitor is being done. This is what the charging of, after applying DC, you are waiting for the charging of capacitor. Now if you see, now we need to calculate the point where we are going to get this point. First point is 2.5 volt, means here it is said 0.5 Vs, means Vs what we have applied. If you see, we have applied the Vs is equal to 5 volt. What will be our this 0.5? It will be, if you multiply 0.5 with 5, it is going to give you 2.5 volt. Now we are going to look at where we are going to get 2. According to the theory, it is coming around 0.7 time period. Now we are going to look at around 0.7 time period. Now let us delete all this one. Now we are going to check our this voltage, capacitance voltage, which is in this one color. Now if you keep our cursor, we are going to check at 2.5. Now we need to keep an eye on 2. Where we are going to get 2.5. Now this is your almost exact location. Now this we got our exact one. Here we are going to get 2. Where at 33.7. So our tau was 47 second, and if you multiply and our where we are going to get 2.5, it is around 33 second. So this must be around 0.7 into 47 second. If you check it, you will get at 0.7 time constant, you are going to have the voltage. Now we are going to see our second result. Means at one time constant, what we are going to get, at whether we are going to get 3.15 volt or not. Now let us delete all this one. Now we are just going to check where we are going to get 3.15. Now let us keep an eye on 3.15. Now we are moving the cursor slowly so that we can see. Now it is around 3.18 only. So let us see at that point only. 3.18 volt, what is that value? 47 second. Means here also 3.15 volt we are going to get at one time constant. See, one time constant means 47 second we are getting it. Now we need to at 5 time constant, means at 235 hertz, at 235 second, what is the capacitance value? We have means at 5 time constants. Now delete this one, means at, now we are going to look at the horizontal axis, 237, at 237. Now this is the value that we were talking, at 237 around, at 5 time constant, the capacitance value is almost 5 volt. So it is taking 5 time constant to charge completely to 5 volt. So this much amount of time is taken, which is equal to 5 time constant, 5 tau. What is 1 tau? It is around 47. So 1 tau is around 47. At 1 tau it reaches around 3.15 volt only. At 1 tau it is 3.15, and at least it will take 5 time constant to reach the maximum value. So this is all about the charging time constant. Now if you want to, let us draw, now if you want to see the curve, now let me show the curve how it looks. It will be same, this is your capacitor charging. Now if you compare with this one at 5 time constant, at this C 5 time constant, it is come to steady state, and you are at 1 time constant, you are going to get 0.63 volt, which was around 3.15 volt, and at 0.7 time constant you are going to get 2.5, which we were getting. So this, the curve is same. Now I think we have seen everything. Now let us see if anything is left over there. Now almost everything we have seen. Now this is what it is saying, VC. Now this is the voltage across capacitor after 100 seconds. With this formula it has calculated, see it is 4.4 volt. Now we will be checking from here. Now this is the formula, means at 100, now we are just going to look at the 100 second. Now just go here, it is around 107, 105, 199, at almost 100, this is almost this is almost 100 second. Now see, at around 100 second, this is 100.2 second, what is that value? 4.4, and what is that calculator? It is 4.4, means it is matching with the our 4.4. The main discussion is that it takes one time constant to reach around 0.63 volt, and it takes 5 time constant to reach the maximum voltage. So this is all about the charging operation of RC circuit. Now this is all about the RC circuit. Next class we will be doing the discharging circuit.